Hello children, let us continue chapter number 8, comparing quantities. Today we are learning about GST, goods services tax, and then we may do exercise 8.2. Okay children? Children, GST means goods and services tax. It was introduced by Government of India from July 1, 2017. It is levied on supply of goods or services are bought. Let us understand GST by one example. The cost of a pair of roller skates at a shop was ₹450. The GST charge was 5%. Find the bill amount. Children, here cost price is given. It is ₹450. And GST we have to calculate on this amount. It is set 5%. So 5% of 450. 5% means 5 by 100. Of means into. So 5 by 100 into 450. And on simplification, we get ₹22.50. Therefore, bill amount or the sale price of the item, it is equal to cost of the item plus GST. Cost of the item is, cost price is ₹450 plus GST ₹22.50. On adding, we get ₹472.50. Therefore, the bill amount is ₹472.50. And this GST we can find using unitary method also. Here we use the formula method. 5% of 450. Here we can say 5% means on ₹100 GST is ₹5. And total CP is here ₹450. So on ₹450 GST is equal to 5 by 100 into 450. On simplification, here also we get ₹22.50. So GST, you can use this formula or this unitary method. Okay children, any method you can accept, it is your choice. Children, now let us do exercise 8.2. Question number 1. A man got a 10% increase in his salary. If his new salary is ₹1,54,000, find his original salary. Here, it is said in question, the person has 10% increase in his salary and new salary is ₹1,54,000. You have to find the original salary. So children, 10% increase in salary means when original salary is ₹100, then increase is ₹10 and the new salary is ₹110. Here, in question asked original salary, so let us bring original salary on the right hand side and new salary on the left hand side in the step. When new salary is ₹110, then original salary is ₹100. When new salary is ₹1, then original salary is children ₹100 by 110. And then when new salary is ₹1,54,000, then original salary is 100 by 110 into 1,54,000. And this zero and 100 zero get cut and we have 10 by 11 into 1,54,000 and 1,54,000 divided by 11 we get 14,000 and into 10 we get 1,40,000. Okay children, so this is the original salary and the same answer we can use by using formulas. Let the original salary be X because we don't know what is the original salary, so we are assuming as X. Increase in salary equal to 10% of the original salary. That means 10% means 10 by 100 into x. This is 10x by 100. And original salary plus increase in the salary is equal to new salary. Original salary we have assumed as x plus increase in salary we got as 10x by 100 is equal to ₹1,54,000, which is the new salary. Okay, children. Now here we have to take LCM. So LCM taking time we write as 100x by 100 plus 10x by 100 equal to 1,54,000. Adding time we get 100x plus 10x we can add. 110x divided by 100 equal to 1,54,000. Therefore 100x 110x equal to 1,54,000 into 100 we have to cross multiply. And therefore x equal to whatever we have on the right side we write divided by 110. And simplification time we get 1,40,000. So the original salary is ₹1,40,000. Okay children, here we have used the unitary method and here the formula method. Okay, any method you can choose. Okay children. Question number 2. On Sunday, 845 people went to the zoo. On Monday, only 169 people went. What is the percentage decrease in the people visiting the zoo on Monday? Children, here, number of people went to the zoo on Sunday is equal to 845. Number of people went to the zoo on Monday is equal to 169. So we can find the difference of the people visiting the zoo on Monday by subtracting 169 from 845. So we get 676. And here asked a decrease percentage. Then here I have used the formula method. Decrease percent is equal to here decrease percent. So we write the decrease number first. Decrease divided by total people into 100. So what is the decrease in the number of people, children? We have already found as 676. 676 divided by total number of people 845 into 100. Okay, so here simplification time we get 80%. Children, how you have done? You can do simplification. See here, children, 676 divided by 845 into 100. So here 100 and 845 we cut first with a 5, because here units place is 0, here units place is 5, so we can cut these numbers by 5. So 845 cutting by 5 we get 169, and 100 by cutting by 5 we get 20. Okay, now we have 169 and 676. So 169 you can divide 676 by 169 directly. So you just check with the 9 table, 9 fours are 36 getting now. So you can think, you can try, and you will get 676 by 169 as 4 by directly cutting by 169. Now we have 4 and 20 left with. So 4 into 20 we have to multiply 4. So we get 4 into 20 is our 80%. Okay, children. And the same decrease percent we can find using a unitary method. You know, children, Monday, how many people came? 845 people. So considering this number, what is the decrease we got? 676. So on 100 people, how much decrease came? 676 divided by 845 into 100. So simplification I have already shown here. It is also 80%. So any method you choose, answer will be same. Okay, children. Question number 3. A shopkeeper buys 80 articles for rupees 2400 and sells them for a profit of 16%. Find the selling price of one article. Then here, cost price of 80 articles is equal to rupees 2400 and profit is given as 16%. So let us find profit. Profit is equal to 16% of rupees 2400. 16% means 16 divided by 100 into 2400. Here I use the formula method. Okay, children. And here these two zeros of 100 get cut with the two zeros of 2400. Now we have 16 into 24. So multiplying time we get 384. So profit is rupees 384. Now we have to find the selling price of the articles. Here asked to find the selling price of one article. So let us find selling price of first 80 articles. Okay, here selling price equal to CP plus profit. CP is given as rupees 2400 plus profit we got as 384. So adding time we get rupees 2784. Okay, and this is the selling price of 80 articles. So what is the selling price of one article? How can we get a selling price of one article? We have to divide total SP divided by number of articles. So what is total selling price? Rupees 2784 divided by number of articles 80. So dividing time we get 34.80. This is the selling price of one article. Okay, children, here I have used the formula method, right? Question number 4. The cost of an article was rupees 15,500. Rupees 450 were spent on repairs. If it is sold for a profit of 15%, find the selling price of the article. Children, here the cost price of the article is rupees 15,500. Amount spent on repairs equal to rupees 450. So we have to find the effective cost price. Effective cost price of the article is equal to CP plus repair charge. Here CP is rupees 15,500 plus repair charge is rupees 450. So adding time we get 15,950. So this is the effective cost price. And profit is given as 15%. So we have to find the profit on effective CP. Okay. So 15% of rupees 15,950. 15% means 15 by 100 into 15,950. And children, here simplification time we get rupees 2,392.50. Simplification I have shown here 15 by 100 into 15,950. So 10 and 100 zero cut with. Then we have 15 by 10 here and we are cutting by 5. Cutting by 5 we get downside 2 and upside 3. Now we have to multiply 3 into 1595. Then we have to divide that answer by 2. So we get the answer rupees 2392.50. Okay children. Now selling price of the article. What's the formula? Selling price CP plus profit. Here we have effective CP. So we are using effective CP plus profit. So it is rupees 15,950 plus rupees 2,392.50. Adding these two numbers, we get rupees 18,342.50. This is the selling price of the article. Okay, children. Question number 5. A VCR and TV were bought for rupees 8,000 each. The shopkeeper made a loss of 4% on the VCR and a profit of 8% on the TV. Find the gain or loss percent on the whole transaction. Okay, so here, children, the purchasing price is set. VCR's purchasing price is 8,000 and TV's purchasing price is also 8,000. Then he sold both items and then he got loss on VCR 4% and a profit of 8% on the TV. We have to find whether the shopkeeper got gain, profit or loss in the transaction. Okay, so we have to find, children, how can we find loss or profit? We have to find SP and CP and then we have to compare them. Okay, so cost price of VCR is equal to rupees 8,000. Cost price of TV is equal to rupees 8,000. So total cost price is 8,000 plus 8,000 is equal to rupees 16,000. Now, loss on VCR, it is at 4% of 8,000. So 4% means 4 by 100 into 8,000. So 2 zeros of 100 and 8,000 get cut and we have 80 here and here 4. 80 fours are 320. And selling price of VCR equal to, what's the formula children? If loss is there, what formula we can use? CP minus loss. So rupees 8,000 minus rupees 320 and subtracting time we get rupees 7,680. Now next item TV, we have got profits here. So profit on TV is equal to 8% of 8,000. 8% means we can write as 8 by 100, of means into 8,000. And here 2 zeros of 100 and 8,000 get cut and 80 into 8 we are having here. So 80 into 8 we get 640. So profit on TV is rupees 640. So selling price of TV, what's the formula children? CP plus profit. And CP here 8,000 and profit we got as 640. Adding time we get rupees 8,640. So we can now find out total selling price, that is selling price of VCR plus selling price of TV. Selling price of VCR is rupees 7,680 plus selling price of TV is rupees 8,640. And these two adding time we get rupees 16,320. And you know children, 16,320 is greater than 16,000. That is SP is greater than CP. So the shopkeeper has profit in the deal. Okay, so in the transaction. So profit is equal to, let us apply formula, SP minus CP. SP here 16,320 minus CP total is rupees 16,000. So subtracting time we get rupees 320. Therefore profit percent is equal to profit divided by CP into 100. What is profit children here? 320 and CP is, total CP is 16,000 into 100. And here this children, this two zeros of 16,000 and 100 get cut and we have 160 down set, 320 again 10 and 320 zero cut. We have here 32 and 16. So cutting time we get 2. So the profit percentage is 2%. Okay, children.